All right, welcome to Mafia 3. I wanted to make a kind of a longer let's play of this game just to promote the Humble Bundle monthly deal that's going on right now. For $12, you get Mafia 3, Deus Ex, Mankind Divided, and I think it's called God Eater. It's like a Japanese RPG game. But I really wanted to make a video just promoting that because I feel like it's a really good deal for $12. But we'll talk about it later. We'll watch the beginning of this.
New Bordeaux. A modern city with traditional southern values.
I underestimated how far he was going to go. What he was willing to do.
Visit the historic French Ward and enjoy local cuisine at one of our five-star restaurants.
Killing them wasn't enough. Lincoln Clay was using them to send a message.
Or spend the afternoon in the bayou and take in its natural splendor.
Sal Marcano had no idea what he was going to unleash.
New Bordeaux. Safe. Family-oriented farm. Make it your next vacation destination.
This city survived the War of 1812, the Civil War, and God knows how many hurricanes. But when Lincoln Clay went after the mob, he inflicted more damage than all the wars and hurricanes combined.
Lincoln's mother abandoned him in 1947, a couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican. I always figured his father was white, maybe even Italian. Not that it mattered. Back then, if you looked black, you black. Same as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until 1958.
Graphics are amazing.
When did you meet?
Facial animations.
1966. I was running black ops out of Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA-DOD task force.
He's a quiet boy. Good boy.
Two Purple Hearts, a Bronze Star, and the Distinguished Service Cross. He served his country with honor and distinction.
After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approved, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned, they're always looking for a home. Always looking for a place to belong. I think he thought he'd find it in the army. Thing is, once that's lost, you can never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money. And he needed Lincoln's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
All right.
Still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grabbed the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here.
All right, but yeah, the deal that's going on right now, it's only for like a day. I'm a little late. I should have made a video like a couple weeks ago just telling you guys about it, but I had to leave for work and I forgot about it
hey
until
man, grab those keys.
Yesterday. And hold up. Holy shit. Yeah, I thought it was a really good deal, so that's why I'm doing this little promotion for it. I'm not, like, sponsored by Humble Bundle or anything. I just wanted to share this good deal with you guys. Plus,
keys in another room. Grab them so we can get the hell out of here.
Yeah, if you want, like, I'm not, like, forcing you or, like, coercing you. That's how you say it. But I do have a referral code. I'll put it in the description if you wanna use that. It basically just credits my Humble Bundle account $8 or something like that. And yeah, I get to use that for other games that are being sold on the website. Like I can't use the money anywhere else, so it's just basically credits for buying games and stuff. So if you want to use that, you don't have to. I just thought I'd say something about it.
Hey man, grab those keys.
But yeah, let's we'll probably play like a few, maybe an hour or two of this game, and yeah, we'll see what it's like. I've already played Deus Ex Mankind Divided. That's the other game, and I haven't tried God Eater yet. I probably will eventually.
Lincoln, pick up the keys.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck just like we asked. He would grease his partner to make it look good. If you got doubts, I'll take the chance.
I'm not gonna kill him. I could kill him. Can I knock him out? Oh, shit, never mind. Damn it, I thought that was to knock him out.
Goddamn.
Alright. I'm a monster. Leave no witnesses.
You got the keys, so you can drive.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Why do I gotta drive? But yeah, I'm running this game on medium right now. It looks pretty good, but like, that's the thing about when this game first came out. It didn't really run that well, and I think it was capped at 30 FPS. I mean, I'm getting like 55 frames per second right now. It's on medium, so just gives you like, if your computer can handle it, should be able to. Come on, start it. There we go. I already know I'm gonna get a copyright strike, or not strike, just a.
Oh. Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses.
Get out of my way. Goddamn.
The old man wanted us to keep one of the guards alive, help throw the feds off the trail.
Like you said, I take a chance. Besides, if I learn anything from being over in Nam, someone's willing to flip sides once, they're probably willing to do it a second time. Fuck you in the process.
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh? Are you going to answer the question or what?
Yeah. We're on the coast of Quang Nai, evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting them onto a medical ship. This woman walks up. She's got a baby in one hand and a leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops and tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. The MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Wow.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were going to tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, god damn.
It's not a fault. Sometimes not like you think. You just want conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day you're raising cattle, so tending your rice. Meaty, you next day everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig.
Juicy meat. And all that melted cheese dribbling down your chin. Nothing fills you up faster or satisfies that deep down hunger better. Two big all beef patties, American cheese, tomato, lettuce, and Hank's special sauce all piled high on a sesame seed bun. The Big Hank, only at Hank's.
I really like the graphics. The
Brazilians probably won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
I'll just leave it under the seat. Time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck.
There's nothing a man loves more than an ice-cold Stoltz beer.
Can't a woman appreciate one, too?
Back it up to the loading dock.
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language, and...
Well, ain't like I never been called nigga before.
I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
When I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right.
He's got a shotgun.
Here we go.
Put your IDs up to the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
I like this guy's accent.
What the fuck is this shit heel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet. You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burn room. How much y'all bring in?
The burn room.
$38,546. Small bills, mostly. I'll let Miss Gale call up to your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery.
Appreciate it.
This way? What is this guy doing?
Need to check that scattergun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Buying rooms down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. He just got out the service.
And my cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job, but ain't your nigga who staggers in his hide on the spot.
All right, let's go.
Bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you! Christ, look at that.
Got all that gold.
Y'all held that much gold.
That Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. It doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are. Put those bags on the table there.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
It gets the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck, that's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Hear some guy come around the house trying...
I bet that felt pretty good.
God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
Give me a second.
You take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know what the fuck I'm doing.
Nice. Stealth.
Called over there last night, told them I wanted to sell it. Told them they needed to be out in 2 weeks. And the man, his name's, John, starts Huh?
He didn't see.
Huh?
Go!
Nice. Switching weapons, hold LB, yeah, quick swap, holster,
get over here, man.
Oh, I hope this combination skeletor got us is legit.
I'll be damned. All right, go for it, Godzilla.
Holy fucking shit.
It's beautiful. All right, I'm gonna take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch you with that drill, we're gonna start throwing this down.
Triggered the fucking alarm?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. All right, we're gonna hold off the guards until Danny's done drilling. Hey, you gonna pull this off.
Shoddy. Where are they shooting from? There. Where is this guy? Aim assist. I put on aim assist because... Wait, I want this one. So much easier to use a controller.
Only way we walk out of here is if we get the weapon stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
My old man gonna shit a brick when he hears about this. Fuck! Fuck! Come on, open!
Give me that damn thing.
Expose the lock. Move the... Okay. Grab the machine gun. Couple of adrenaline boosts. All right, we're good to go.
Shit, man, these guys ain't fucking around.
Faced way worse than this over in Nam. Little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault. Watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes. What?
I can't see them.
Well, Sammy had men all over the place. Now, one of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery. Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
That scene kind of ended up abruptly.
You just come from Vietnam?
Don't you think?
That's right. I was a Marine in the Pacific. You take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
That's a nice car.
Sorry I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Me as how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it. It was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your cop.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home.
All right, got to set a route or a route here. Yeah.
Sammy's doing all right.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing
Whoops.
The walls.
What if first the thing I do crashes? Is crash
what
it.
If the train's delayed, what if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you.
Ah!
Damn, you're scratching the paint!
I can't drive.
Anyhow, like I was saying, he'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets.
The cops.
You remember Marty and Ron Langford?
Sure.
They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want something. I say, sure. Free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than 3 words and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with. Fucking around aside, that was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
There's no way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he'd keep his old man from fighting out. We'll steer clear of the hollow in Frisco, just selling the French wall. Georgie's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. Georgie's a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree to a 3-way split.
I don't know. I kinda need to lay low a bit, figure some things out.
Yeah, all right.
He couldn't get out that door.
Look who I found panhandling out in front of the train station.
Pleasure, man.
Boy, I send you to bring Lincoln Clay home. Not the big nigga who ate him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son. How are you?
I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love corn whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did. I'm so, so proud of you. Pour Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
Pour Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
Good to see you.
You look so good.
Nice seeing you, Lincoln. Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now who wants to get shit-faced? Woo!
It's hard to explain what it's like coming home from war. Elation. Fear. Guilt. Imagine being trapped in a dark room and there's no way out. And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you. And there's no escape from any of it. And then, one day, a door opens, and you're free to go. Just like that. The thing is, you made your peace with your terror and your fear of death. And now part of you is afraid to leave it behind. But what choice do you have? Every soldier has to walk through that door. One way or another.
Man, whiskey's going hoy in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as you left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you wanna crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up.
Go to bed. Oh. Playboy. Let's take a look at that. And we got a Playboy magazine. Oh, shit. There's some nudity here. All right. I'm already gonna get a copyright ID anyways. This doesn't matter. You run again? I'm not sure.
We barely have two nickels to rub together, now we're paying for all that food. Jesus Christ!
Watch that mouth of yours.
We wouldn't be in this mess if you would have listened to me.
What mess?
It's not something you need to worry about, Lincoln. I got it under control.
Under control? God damn it, you need
to— Boy, I'm not warning you again!
Have it your way, old man!
Let him be. He needs to cool off.
You mind telling me what's got him so riled up?
We've been having, problems with the Haitians. But like I say, I got it under control.
Well, truck's all loaded up. I figure we got enough out there for— Should I come back?
In honor of your returning to us safe and sound, I made a donation to Father James here. Supplied him with food he can hand out to some of our needier family.
I was hoping you'd lend me a hand, Lincoln, and give you a chance to see the neighborhood.
This thing with the Haitians, how serious is it?
Ah, you know Ellis. Someone looks at him the wrong way, he's on them like a wet dog.
Like I said, I can come back.
Nonsense. Lincoln needs to get out. Enjoy the day. Besides, be good for the two of you to spend some time together. Go on. Those people waiting on their food.
Oh, I saw Langan a couple times once he was first back.
There's so many cinematics.
He told me he wanted to leave town, head out to California. Now, he had a friend in the service who could get him a job working at the Mare Island shipyard. And the only reason he came back was to tell Sammy and Ellis goodbye. But then he found out about the trouble Sammy was having with those Haitians. So he decided to stay and help. Those Haitians, they are bad news. No talking Lincoln out of it. Whatever else he might have become, Lincoln was always loyal.
Warm Hearts Neighborhood Kitchen.
Welder, most likely. 3-month apprenticeship to start, then the union lets you in.
You tell Sammy and Ellis?
Not yet. Gonna wait a few days. Didn't want to spring it on them since I just got back.
Shit. Damn it.
Don't like to hear it, but they'll come around.
Sorry. Got a random pop-up.
Best for you. Go ahead and start serving those folks. I'll be back.
Give Sammy my best, Lincoln.
Yes, sir.
Warm meal, warm heart. Oh, sure.
Oh, you gotta hold X. Just staring at him.
Thanks.
Nice to see you. You delivering a real blessing here, Lincoln. Thank you.
Blessing's mine, ma'am.
Couple of days back and they already got you working?
I'm happy to do it.
Means a hell of a lot to all of us.
Don't get old, son. It's a fucking shit show.
I'll see what I can do about that.
Hey there, Lincoln.
How are you, Regine?
I'm good. Nice to see you around the holler again.
Nice to see those big brown eyes again.
Well, they'll be over at my aunt's place with the rest of me.
Who the hell is that?
Maybe I'll do that.
Lincoln, we got trouble!
Run, Regine!
What's the gun with you, Lincoln? Sammy's next!
Motherfuckers over here!
I screwed that up.
You're not with us. You're against us.
You didn't even fire at me. It's my gun now.
Francois Papadoc Duvalier was elected president of Haiti in 1957. By 1959, he had created a secret police called Tonton Macoute, and people started to flee. Most of them settled in the southern United States. Now, mixed in with the good, hard-working people were hardened criminals. They formed the backbone of what became the Haitian gang. Now, Lincoln found out they set up in the swamps and were led by a man named Baca.
You and Father James done already?
Got jumped by the Haitians. It's time you level with me. Tell me what's really going on.
Yes. I suppose it is. Six 7 months ago, folks in the Hollow started getting robbed. Money, jewelry, things of that nature. Didn't take long for us to figure out it was the Haitians. Then those batas on Valor started going after the lottery.
How much money are we talking about? How much?
Enough that we're in deep shit with Sal Marcano. Haven't kicked up to him in 3 months.
Jesus Christ. If I deal with them, that gives us time to settle up with Marcano, right?
Let me worry about Sal. He and I go way back. But this thing with the Haitians, it's time for it to end. You and Ellis need to handle it.
How are we gonna find them?
Back in the 20s, folks used to pull salt out of the bayou. They even built themselves a little shanty town. When the Depression hit, they abandoned it. That's the only place this could have come from.
We're gonna need guns and ammo.
Call this number. But do it away from here. No sense tipping anybody off.
Or we could sweep the Hollow, track down and kill every last one of those cocksuckers, then we wouldn't have to worry about it.
The last thing folks in this neighborhood need to see is colored people killing each other. Do this quiet, away from here.
Once we eliminate whoever's running the show, the rest of them will go down on their own. Trust me.
All right, soldier boy. I follow your lead.
Be careful, yeah? Those Haitians are a hard people. Do not ever underestimate them. Celui que sait diverse sait suscite hostility.
You sure this is how you want to play this?
Last thing they're gonna expect is an attack from the water. You head back round to the row. Stay with the car. I'll meet you over there when this is done.
Hope you know what you're doing.
Trust me, Ellis. Here in a bit, this will all be behind us.
Oh, was I supposed to jump off? Stalk your enemies to avoid attention. Get too close or make noise.
After Perlis. Boss says if we have to burn down half the Hollow to get to Sammy, we're doing it. Ain't stopping till that old man is dead.
Him, Ellis, and the other one.
There's another way we can go over here.
He's the one. This time you won't get away from us.
Papa Legba, open the gate for me.
Take him out first. All right, hopefully this guy doesn't see us. I'm gonna try to do this stealthy. Cool. Wait, I think if you throw these guys into the water, alligators eat them. I'm gonna try that. Yeah, and I got an achievement. Bon appetit. Anybody down here? No. Tommy gun. Or no, that's Barker 390. I think I'd rather have the sniper shotgun, but let's just keep this. It has more ammo.
Should have killed that old man a long time ago.
Think the boss.
Whistling. Whistle to draw enemies away and thin out the group. Oh shit, I didn't even see.
Ask him to come down on us.
That cracker asshole don't give a shit about some worn out nigga. I heard something.
All right. I didn't see what key it was. Shit, this guy better turn around. Oh man, this is going to go bad. Screw it. Shit. I guess we're not being stealthy. Doing it this way is more fun.
Watch out!
Oh, right there. He's shooting at the wall. I like the animations of them getting shot. I mean, I think they look cool, I just... Yeah.
I'll blow your head off.
Oh, big guy. Need more. I need a different weapon. This guy's still alive. I don't need more. Right in the face. Where is he? I was right there. This guy's still alive. Show your face. It's tough.
After the hollow.
Is that Baka?
That's why he's just a coward! That's why it's all... Fuck me! Not on such a white man!
The man you're talking about took me in when I had nowhere else to go.
You are no better than you!
Holy sh...
You can't take those souls! You fucking pig! Damn you to her!
Take it easy!
Take it easy! Take it easy! He kept me in there, locked in there, day and night. Beat me, use me, I killed you, motherfucker! You and your entire goddamn family!
He's dead! He's dead! He can't hurt you anymore. It's over.
Over? Over! This is never going to be over. Pajam!
Pajam, what's that? What does that mean?
Fucking Haitians.
He's coming this way. Captain, these boys in there. Motherfuckers over here!
Oh, we got a grenade now. Oh, jeez. Molotovs. Right bumper. Alright. It's raining. I don't think a Molotov will do that. Be that useful in this condition. Need more ammunition. Grab the shoddy.
Make him bleed. Getting behind something.
Gotta reload, damn it.
Knew that. I knew that was gonna explode. A red barrel. Classic. Oh, they still think I'm over there.
Hot damn.
He's something with a little bit more range. Now they see me.
He keeps killing us.
Oh, shit. Can't remember how to use an adrenaline shot.
Fucker's dead. You out of your mind, motherfucker?
We ain't your people, cocksucker.
Out of bullets. Go to reload.
He's fucking killing us.
Molotov, here we go.
Molotov, run!
Shit. Alright, how do I use heals? I think it's up. Shit, I can't remember. I'll figure it out later.
About fucking time.
Oh, that's my guy. Alright, let's get out of here. Does he want me to drive? Driving and explosives to destroy pursuing vehicles. Drop, press down. Okay.
Always gotta get you out of trouble, don't I?
You old?
I am. How'd it go with Box?
We came to an understanding. He stayed dead and I let him. Let's get back to Sammy's.
Can't even tell you how happy Pops is gonna be. And this shit with the Haitians has been weighing on him.
With them out of the way, things will calm down. Go back to how they should be.
Been telling him for months we needed to do something like this, but Pops, he... I don't know. Sometimes I think he's lost the taste for this shit.
Just because a man don't rush to violence don't mean he lost something.
I know, just makes me wonder what happens after, you know?
No, I don't know.
Explain it to me.
Don't matter if it's a bullet or the hand of God. We all go sometime, right?
I suppose. But Ellis, we don't need to talk.
I pray that Pops outlives the both of us. But if he doesn't, every motherfucker in the Hollow's gonna be looking to us or gunning for us. Just saying, we gotta be ready when that day comes.
Yeah, well, that's not something we gotta worry about right now. So just cool it with your grand plans, all right?
Yeah, all right.
Can't turn. Oh yeah, the clouds. I remember watching Angry Joe's review. He said the clouds look terrible. They actually kind of, I mean, they're not awful, but they're not really that great too, so. Yeah, this is where I park. Oh, I gotta go in the garage.
The thing Lincoln didn't understand, or maybe want to understand, is that for a man like Sammy, there's always gonna be more Haitians. Now, if there wasn't someone going after Sammy, then there was someone else forcing him into a bad situation. It was never going in. That's how Mankin ended up working for Sal Marcano.
You were right about those Haitians being down by that old salt mine. They won't be bothering us again.
It was a mistake sending you down there. I should handle my own business.
This isn't any different than what I was doing before I left.
You probably don't know this. But every night on the TV, right after the news, they show the names of all the boys killed over there in Vietnam. I'd be sitting in the kitchen eating my supper, watching that list scroll by, wondering if today is the day I finally see your name.
But you never did. Nothing happened to me.
There's only so much luck down the well. Sooner or later, pull up that bucket, there's nothing in it.
So, what are we gonna do about Marcano?
Pay him his goddamn money one way or the other.
Lottery gonna be enough to cover it?
The lottery? No. But Sal called a bit ago. Wants you to meet him up the country club. Says he's got something in the works. Square things up between us.
The only black folk allowed in there to help.
Now, they may not like it, but they're not gonna say no to Sal Marcano. He says you get to come in, you get to come in.
Fine. Always did want to see the inside of that place.
You need to do whatever Sal asks, yeah? For all our sakes.
Yes, sir.
All right, let's do it.
Welcome back to Native Son, dear listener.
Driving mode. For a more realistic driving experience, advanced players may wish to play using simulated driving. I could try that. Let's do that. Slow-mo driving. To use slow-mo, press Y. Okay. I didn't know that was in here. Alright. Alright, let's turn on realistic driving.
Now you tell her Remy sent you, and it's by two.
Driving mode, simulation. Can't beat that. See if it's any different.
Go on over there and tell her I sent you.
Oh, gotta turn here.
I know I'm not supposed to enjoy my coffee on air. Oh, Gilbert's turning red, folks.
Doesn't feel that different.
Oh, I tell you, we like to have our fun, dear listener. And that's what Mardi Gras is going to be all about. Good old-fashioned new Bordeaux F-U-E.
Holy shit. All right, yeah, it's a little different.
But I am.
I like it, though.
About being honored to be part of the crew.
Kind of wish you could go first person.
We got a heck of a plan for y'all, and we have
spent... Is there a way to go first person? Let's see. No, there isn't.
Will be my first crew.
There's probably a mod that lets you drive first person.
Dear listener, you know how important Mardi Gras was to him. God rest his soul, he was one of the crew of Knights Founders. He was captain for more years than I can remember, and Daddy was Rex back in 1932, for those of you whose memories go all the way back there. Oh, you know, I tell you, he'd spend weeks, that months, preparing. More than anything else, it was the tradition, the feeling of being
part one sec.
Of this city that
can I turn down the engine sounds? It's so loud compared to everything else.
Contributed to the greater whole. Those Reds over in Russia.
It'd probably be sound effects. Home,
they try to sell that as equality. No, sir.
There's yeah, there we go.
Be a king. And each king has his day. I'll tell you, that coffee sure is fine. On the next episode, you better believe we're going to talk about this here story that President Johnson is considering a deal with the Russians to scale back our nuclear program. We're going to have that and a lot more right here on Native Son.
Get some air. Oh shit.
See the pyramids along the Nile. Watch the sunrise on a drop.
Oh man, I'm not even looking at the map. Talk to security.
Send me photographs.
The fuck you doing up here? Help goes into the back.
I'm here to see Mr. Marcano. The name's Lincoln Clay.
That a fact? I'll be goddamned. Mind your manners while you're in there, boy, or there'll be hell to pay, you hear?
Mess up his lawns. His lawn.
Lincoln Clay! Christ, man, get a look at you! I bet those fucking gooks shit themselves when they saw you coming.
Been a long time, Georgie.
Oh, no shit, it's been a long time. I think the last time I saw you was that night over in the French ward, right before you shipped out. Damn if that wasn't a gas.
Oh, I seem to remember me and Ellis running from the cops. And Danny ending up in the drunk tank.
Hell, man, I bailed him out. Besides, it was worth it to knock the hell out of them cracker assholes. Smoke?
Sure.
Oh, man.
Sammy said Mr. Marcano wanted to see me.
Mr. Marcano? Shit. Make him sound like a goddamn lawyer. You just call him Sal. Come on, he's in the back.
I should have wore something else.
A little underdressed.
You can take it up with my old man. He'll tell him to kiss his ass. Nice thing about having fuck you money.
I'll let
Olivia, I hate to cut this short, darling, but I've got a meeting coming up. Remy, a pleasure as always, sir. Two more glasses.
Lincoln, good to see you. This is Vito Scaletta.
Oh.
He's the one I've been telling you about.
He's from the Mafia, too, I think. Pretty sure.
So you served in Vietnam, huh?
Yes, sir.
Sal tells me you earned a few pieces of tin over there.
Well, I served with some good men. Nothing I did would happen without them.
Army? Marines?
Regular Army at first, and then I was recruited to the 5th SFG.
Special Forces.
I told you it was something else. Now, not that anything's gonna go wrong, but just in case, goddamn, don't you want a man like that on your side?
Well, if you're vouching for him, Sal, that's good enough for me. Look, I got a couple things to take care of. Thanks for the drink.
Christ, that guy's an asshole. Fucking carpetbagger. Commission sent him down here from Empire Bay about 15 years back. He's been a pain in my goddamn ass ever since. Well, I guess you're wondering what this is all about.
Yeah, Sammy didn't tell me too much.
Twice a year, the feds take old money out of circulation and destroy it. Over the course of the next few days, that money's gonna be delivered here to the reserve in town.
And you're gonna hit one of those shipments?
No, sir. We are gonna use that occasion to gain access to their vault.
And then steal everything that ain't nailed down. Should be $6-7 million in there, easy.
That's pretty fucking ballsy.
It's a chance of a goddamn lifetime is what it is.
Now, Vito's fronting a lot of the money for the job, and he got us the combination to the vault. Hey, you had a chance to see Danny?
No, not yet.
Oh, well, you will. We brought him and his old man in on this, and they're gonna need your help, so go see them. They're still in that same place.
There's something else we gotta talk about. Now, safe to assume you know about the problem Sammy's been having.
I took care of the Haitians. Once things settle down, money will start coming in again.
You see that right there? That's what I'm talking about. You didn't sit around with your thumb jammed in your ass. You saw a problem, you went out and took care of it. Goddamn, I take that over money any day of the week.
We pay our own way, debts and all. Always have.
Oh, hell, son, I know that. I wouldn't expect otherwise. But you know, even after we all evened up, you're still gonna be slopping around in the ass end of this city. Not much of a future in that. But maybe there's a different way forward, you understand? For all of us.
What'd you have in mind?
I want you to know I mean no disrespect when I say this. Sammy's a hell of a man, but he's not getting any younger. And I'm thinking it's time to make a change.
Well, I don't think that Ellis is ready for that kind
of... I'm not talking about Ellis. I'm talking about you. I want you to run the holler.
I can't do that.
Well, look here. If you're worried about Sammy, don't you understand? Now, he's always been on the level with me. And this job we're talking about, there's more than enough for him to retire on.
He took me in when I had nowhere else to go. Treated me like a son. I'm sorry, Mr. Marcano. I can't do that to him.
Well, shit, son. I'd be lying if I didn't say I wasn't just a little disappointed. But I get it. You're loyal. Which is something that is scarce these days.
Do you still want me to help with this thing we've been talking about?
You goddamn right I do! And when it's all done, you all be more than square with me. You have my word.
What do you really want to hear? That we'd kidnap and torture anyone suspected of working with the VC? I'm trying to ascertain the level of training that Lincoln Clay received during his time in Vietnam.
Someone like that you don't need to train. You point them in the right direction, you get the fuck out of their way.
Looking.
Can't see a goddamn thing.
Gotta be here somewhere. Let's just keep looking. Neither can they. Stay cool. We'll get through this.
Motherfuckers.
Intel view. Use Intel view to track enemies. Really?
He's right there. There, fucking move.
Well, I can't. That doesn't make sense that we have that. That's kind of weird. I'm not complaining. It makes it easier, but it's just,
Jesus Christ.
It's weird. It's like having Witcher senses. Regroup with Georgie.
Danny and Ellis just came through with the drill.
Out there, man.
It's too quiet now.
So long. Piece of shit drill kept overheating. You and Lincoln both still in one piece? Yeah, we good. Where's Danny? He's pushing everything off to the side so that we have room to catch the money. All right, well, once you squared away up here, we start dropping it down. We'll make it quick.
Jeez, look at it. Look at his face.
Kill the lights. Just worry about the money. I'll deal with this.
Looking for cover. Got him. Suspect's on the move. Taking his ass out.
All right, we're good. Good.
Fuck, I ain't had this much fun in ages.
They're trying to flush us out. Stay focused on what you're doing.
Swapping cover. That's easy.
Sounds like all hell's breaking loose.
Hell yes.
Lock this place
down.
Taking
cover.
I need a man who can shoot.
Shit. Okay, here we go. Use adrenaline shot. It's up.
Ain't against the law to put in a goddamn massacre.
Don't think this asshole wants me pinned here. How about some help over here? This is a goddamn massacre.
Taking cover.
It's got me stuck. This is a goddamn massacre.
Motherfucker.
All right, we can go.
God damn it, those guards will cut us down the second we make a break for it. Tell Danny he needs to get us out of here.
And these bastards got us pinned down. Y'all need to figure something out. I got some TNT. I'll put out outside the hole and detonate it. What the fuck is that gonna accomplish? If any luck, it'll blow a hole big enough for y'all to drop down. With any luck, Danny, do you even know what the fuck you're doing? Come on, it's dynamite. How complicated could it be? It's lit. Get the fuck away!
Get the fuck away! Jeez, the whole building collapses. God damn it, Danny. Don't want to inhale that stuff.
I'm trying. Danny's leg is pinned. I need your help.
No one really knows why Sal Marcano turned on Thomas Burke, but he took Point Verdun from him and gave it to an enforcer named Roman the Butcher Barbieri, who promptly busted up one of Burke's legs. Now, Danny Burke was part of the heist crew. I mean, he was a gearhead, had never done anything like this before, but Thomas Burke insisted. He figured if the heist was a success, Sal would forgive him and return Point Verdun.
Traitor, all right.
Hey. Now, I heard there ain't nothing sweeter than Vietnamese pussy. You tell me it's true. Casanova Clay. Shit, man, it's so fucking good to see you.
You too, Danny. How's Nikki?
Damn, she wanted to be here, but I ain't remember how I was. God damn, you piece of shit!
Yeah, unfortunately.
Come on, let's grab a beer. Wait for the old man to chill out, and then we can get down to it.
Yeah. What's up, man?
Yeah, I already got it all set up and organized. All the girls gonna be there and everything, except we just gotta go in my cars because we can't roll up in that beat-up piece of shit outside.
Oh, you didn't just call my all-American machine a beater?
I'm just saying, there are better rides out there.
Hey, bullshit there are. This car's a beast. I dropped the custom 358 and a four shipped out.
That ain't the only thing you dropped in her. Maybe you should tell them about how you'd borrow it from Ellis and take the ladies for a ride.
Hell, man, leave me out of this.
Did you fuck in my car?
Nah, ain't no big deal. I was always wrapped up tight. Besides, I already got one fucking bastard in my life. I don't need another one.
All right, you know what? You're going to clean it. Not just the back seat. Every square inch. I don't need to be riding around sitting in your shit. Hey, and you, funny man, you going to fucking help?
Like hell I am. Shit, I didn't get any.
Yeah, well, this is new.
Jesus Christ, you fucking Joker's got about as much chance of pulling this off as I do at winning a goddamn decathlon.
All right, Dad, we hear you.
Donnie and Ellis, you're gonna use the drill to cut a hole up through the bottom of the vault. You and Georgie, you'll be inside. You're to drop the money down, then get the hell out of there. That goddamn drill ain't easy to move, though. So we need a boat to get it through the canals and into position.
Well, Ellis and I worry about the boat. See, George's old man flipped the guard at the reserve, giving you his truck.
Between that and the uniforms, ain't no one gonna give us a second look. Come on, let's get moving. Still gotta swing by Skeletta's and finish up some prep work.
Hey, and you two assholes, don't think this gets you off the hook when it comes to my car. Y'all best get ready to clean it.
I ain't cleaning shit.
Hey, you cleaning it.
My father was a lot of things, few of them good. But he started out smuggling moonshine, so he knew about the canals underneath the city.
There's so much dialogue in the story.
Federal Reserve. It was his idea to use a boat to move the drill into position. He was a real son of a bitch, my father. More than anyone else, I blame him for what happened. Want to stick your own neck out, fine, but leave your son out of it. It's his fault Danny died.
Is everyone in? We need to go.
We're all here. Go, hold it.
All right, we're driving.
Fuck, more guys. We need to get the fuck out of here.
Juke him.
Motherfuckers! Cops cutting off our escape route!
We'll find another way out of here. This tunnel has to go somewhere.
Looking for adventure in whatever comes our way. Yeah, gotta go make it happen. Take the world in a loving place.
It's the fucking cops! They open his fire!
Shoot them!
Cops! Cops! Take that, you fucking pigs! Here they come! Come on then, you sister fucking cunt! Keep going, don't slow down!
Best music for an escape sequence.
Let's see what you got, motherfuckers! Right, punch it, Lincoln. Are you out of your fucking mind? Fuck, fuck, fuck!
Shit.
Everybody all right?
That was the craziest fucking thing I've ever saw.
I'm glad we're breathing and all, but what the hell are we gonna do now?
Only option is to head up.
Are you kidding me? There'll be cops all over the place.
Well, with any luck, they'll be too busy dealing with Mardi Gras. Notice us. Let's go.
Well, damn it, this ain't a gas.
I really like these cutscenes.
Sure, you need to grab that much of my ass.
Oh, shut up and keep climbing.
I know there's a lot of them, but kind of feels like a movie I'm watching right now. Just like Kingdom Come Deliverance. Those cutscenes are really good too.
Alright, once we get out there, I hit a payphone. Call us in a ride.
Can you walk?
Yeah, somebody give me a hand. I can get one.
It's probably just gonna be easier to carry a sorry ass. Hold up. Come here.
Hey, hey! Don't put me the fuck down!
If anybody asks, we say he's drunk. Y'all pick up that money. Let's go.
Oh, god damn it.
It's Mardi Gras. Oh, you see that?
Keep it down.
No, actually, you get a look at her titties? I mean, god damn.
Damn it, shut your mouth before you get us arrested.
Look at that.
Stop, god damn it, stop! Fuck you, pig!
I've never been to Mardi Gras. I think I would like to try it once.
Hey, man, get off the phone. Right fucking now.
I will not be treated in such a manner.
Y'all keep an eye out. We're in some deep shit and need your help.
Where are you?
Just off the parade route. Danny's hurt.
I can't get a car to you because the roads are closed off.
Hello?
Listen.
Hello?
There's a grocery store on the backside of the cemetery. Can you get over there?
Yeah.
There'll be a car waiting at the loading dock. And Lincoln, be careful, yeah? You and Ellie Sport.
We will. Sammy's having a car delivered. It'll be at the loading dock at the grocery store.
God bless you, old man. Let's go.
So I'm guessing we just don't, we try not to attract attention to ourselves. I haven't seen any cops yet.
Come through the bar, Lincoln.
Cops, son, cops tell me the party's over. I'll tell you when the goddamn party's over.
An untold number of painted black officers were killed today when two gunmen robbed the Federal Reserve.
Fuck, you hear that? We made the news. Shut the fuck up, Georgie. We need to keep moving.
Oh, shit.
Fucking time. You need to tell me what you
all
did with the purse.
All units, a robbery was found abandoned beneath the French ward. All units respond. Suspects are a Negro male, approximately 6 foot four.
Watch it.
Hey, careful.
5'11", and two unknown accomplices. They are armed and extremely dangerous.
Fuck, they found the boat.
Stay cool, man. We're still good. Watch it.
Hey, careful.
Watch it.
Buddy is too drunk to find his way home.
Oh, shit.
Don't fucking waste it.
Not that way. Let's go around. Oh man, I can't even go around. Is this guy dead?
I apologize.
Guess we'll just have to. Oh, they don't care.
I'll smack your butt.
Is that a common costume for Mardi Gras? Wearing a raptor head? I think it's an alligator, actually.
What the fuck are we gonna do?
Ellis.
Fucking pigs everywhere.
Ellis, chill out. Everything's gonna be fine. All right, you guys take Danny and the money. Get to the car. I'll deal with the cops. I'll warn them off you.
Hey, no fucking way, man.
It's all right. He ain't going alone. We all got a friend in Jesus.
Amen.
All right. Let's go.
Hey! Over here!
on foot.
Red police zones. All right, we just gotta run.
Responding unit investigating.
Holy shit.
Be advised. Suspect located. On scene units engaging.
Almost died there.
He ain't here. Let's try there.
Is that young man carrying a weapon?
It's such an ugly language, though. I asked her why she wouldn't want to learn French instead. What possible use could she have for Latin? And...
All right, yeah, here's the cemetery.
All units, negative visual on suspect. Repeat, visual contact
lost. Oh, shit. Ran right into that. I should have used stealth, damn it.
Here he is! Get over here!
Oh! Oh, run!
Send me some boys! Shit's going down!
Reload! Attention all units, there's been a homicide in the French ward. Suspect is described as a Negro male. Response requested.
Lined up! Ready to fire! Here he is! Get him!
This is bad. Alright, we're good. Shit.
All units, negative visual on suspect. Repeat, visual contact lost.
Alright, we're good.
Where's Georgie?
We got separated. Before we lost sight of him, he said he'd meet us back at the house.
Code 35. Get in! Suspicious person and vehicle. Responding unit investigated.
All right, yeah, I'm taking this jump. Just gotta make it to the edge, and we're good.
Visual contact with suspect lost.
Well, we managed to get out of this. I'm sleeping on a bed of titties. I don't care what it fucking costs.
They gone?
Yeah, man, they done. I knew we could pull it off. I knew it. We're rich. Fuck.
I'm robbing people with a six gun.
I fought the law, and the law can kiss my ass.
I fought the law and the law lost.
Well, how much is it?
A little over $2 million. Per split. Holy mother God.
Once everything's settled up, I'm calling the man I know, having him bring over 3 hookers.
Boy, ain't all no right. Hooker ever stepping foot in this house.
You sure? Cause 2 of them are for you.
I'm gonna be fucking in my new drifter.
Well, I'd appreciate that.
You know, my entire life, there's always been someone standing over me, telling me where I could go, what I could do, who I could be seen with. This. You boys did tonight. This changes everything. This isn't just money. It's freedom. Real freedom. There ain't no one standing over me again. Over any of us, huh? Vouloir c'est pouvoir, huh?
Well, well, well.
Oh, look man, at the man. Look at the man.
There he is. Oh, and look at what I dug up.
You mind pouring one more of those?
Holy shit. It'll be my pleasure.
Georgie told me shit went sideways during the robbery. Lincoln had to save your ass. You should be damn proud of that, boy.
I am, Sal. More than you'll ever know.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that is some down-home hooch right there, isn't it?
All right.
Listen, I got a guy outside. Y'all mind if he comes in and packs up my cut?
Not at all.
Look
that. Let's see if you can handle this down on mood.
Yeah, why don't you give me some of that?
Trying to get some corn whiskey, make you a man.
They all the same. Hey, take the one on the end. It's your cut, plus what I owe you. Even put in a little extra for your trouble.
Couldn't have pulled it off without you, Sammy. Y'all done right by me tonight. Mwah. Mwah. Why don't you get us something off the top shelf? We need to celebrate.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You ain't got to tell me, yeah. Twice.
Hey, fill me up. All right.
Know something, Lincoln? You're possibly the baddest motherfucker I ever laid my eyes on. But you shouldn't have said no. Where the fuck you think you're going? Fucking niggas.
Come on, grab that bag. Let's go.
When I got to Sammy's, the whole place was burning. I still don't know what brought me there that night. Luck? Divine providence? Or something else? Out of the fire, he woke up long enough to tell me to call John Donovan. So that's what I did. Most days I wish I'd never made that call.
Mr. Donovan, do you know this individual?
Sure. Sal Marcano.
Mm-hmm. And how about this man?
That's Sal's worthless piece of shit brother, Lou. Look, enough of the dog and pony bullshit. What's your real question?
Did you help Lincoln Clay murder Sal Marcano and all prominent members of his crime family?
You're goddamn right I did. I see the moon rising. I see trouble on the way.
I see earthquakes and lightning. I see bad times today. Don't go around tonight. Let's finally take your dad. There's a bad moon on the right. I hear hurricanes blowing. I know the end is coming soon. I feel rivers overflowing. I hear the voice of rage is ruined. Go around
tonight. Finally take your dad. So those the men you're gonna kill, huh?
That's the plan, Padre.
This game makes me want to go smoke a cigarette.
It's a dangerous course you're contemplating.
And what do you think we should do?
Sal Marcano deserves to die. I won't argue otherwise. Kill him. But let that be the end of it.
That's not enough!
It's enough if you say it's enough. I know what Sal did to you, Lincoln. But nothing you do will bring any of them back.
This isn't about bringing them back. Or even exacting some street justice. It's about making that bastard feel what it's like to lose everything. Watch as I take it all away from him.
This is a one-way road, Lincoln. And once you start down it, there ain't no turning back.
I'm going to Sammy's to get my stuff. ready?
I'll be waiting in the car.
Taught us kids to turn the other cheek, not fight back. Problem is, that don't work. Not in the real world.
They must have paid a lot of money to get these songs on the soundtrack.
Hey, Lincoln, we should get going. The Padre doesn't seem too keen on the plan.
You don't need to worry about him.
I'd just hate to encounter any of that Catholic guilt I'm always hearing about.
He knows every low-life thing I've ever done and has never ratted me out. If I say we can trust him, we can trust him.
Fair enough. So you mind telling me what we're really doing?
I'm gonna kill Marcano and all the assholes who work for him.
Bullshit. If that's all you're after, you'd grab an XM21, smear on some face paint, and they'd all be dead before dinner. And you sure as hell wouldn't need a TACOP center and all this other shit you've asked me for.
After I got back, Marcano offered me the hollow, said it was time for Sammy to retire. I told him no.
So you think what happened is your fault?
Hard to see it otherwise.
What do you think Sal was going to do? Host a little party for Sammy? Maybe give him a gold watch and a plaque congratulating him on his retirement? We both know there's only one way out of the life. And you still haven't answered my question.
I'm gonna take over the city, district by district. Marcano wanted me to run the hollow? Fuck him. By the time I'm done, I'll be running the whole goddamn city.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. Assuming, of course, you're up for something that strenuous.
Why the fuck wouldn't I be?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe because you got shot in the face?
I might have lost a step or two, but it'll come back to me. Always does.
God, if that isn't the fucking truth. One other thing. Probably not much of a surprise, but most of the cops in this town are in Sal's pocket.
Yeah, gonna always assume that.
Just being diligent. The cops see you fighting Sal's goons. They're coming after you, every time. You sure you don't need a ride?
Nah, man, I'm good.
I'll be at the motel. Come see me when you're ready.
Welcome home, son.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
Hey, bullshit there are. This guy's a beast. I want you to run the hall.
Said no.
And I wonder what would happen if he said yes.
Fuck?
Be careful.
The game just would just end right after the heist. Go retire.
I still say this is a bad idea, but the boy's dying over there in Vietnam.
There's something I gotta do.
I ever tell you how I got this?
Sure, you stole it.
That idea here. I let the pocket of this old white man just to come around here raising him. Take this with you. It's always brought me good luck.
I can't do that.
I know you think you're alone in this world, Lincoln.
This is how every man shaves, by the way.
Never will be.
It's a Bowie knife. combat knife. Cool. What's in here? Stash. And I got an achievement. Something I've got to do. What is it? Wow, there's 85 achievements. You collected your things from Sammy. All right. Don't have anything in there. But yeah, this is where I'm going to end the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I did. New outfits available. Where's the wardrobe? Let's see that. Take a look at that first. But yeah, if you guys want to see me play more of this game, just let me know in the comments. And I'll play more. Revolutionary. You're black and proud. Show 'em with this leather jacket, turtleneck, and black pants. Fed. Bad, bad Mr. Burke. On the prowl. Wear a suit. Full metal. That's pretty cool. Full metal, too. I like this. Yeah, I'm gonna select this one. This is in full army gear with the helmet and everything. That's pretty cool. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Definitely check out the deal if you want on Humble Bundle monthly. I'll put the link in the description. But I do recommend signing up for that. It's a subscription based program for Humble Bundle. They give you like some really cool games. Whoa. They give you some really cool games, and it's only for like $12. And yeah, it's just every first of the month that you get a new game, and then yeah, they're usually pretty cool. Like this last month was Dark Souls 3, and then the month before that I think it was H1Z1. So it's definitely worth it, is what I'm trying to say. Yeah, thank you guys for watching, and goodbye.